Hey there, I'm Shane, and today I'm going to be talking about the Pelican 1535 Air, which is a hard case designed to be extremely weather resistant and water resistant, as well as being extremely modular to fit realistically anything you want inside it. I use it mainly for my photo and video gear, and I'm going to be reviewing it in that context, and hopefully in this video I'll be able to tell you all about the things I like about it, dislike, and if I think it's a good option for you to buy. So, this is a Pelican 1535 hard case. It's designed to be the perfect size to fit in as a carry-on item on an airplane, which is ideal considering you don't really want to have to check in your expensive camera gear or whatever you have inside it in the luggage compartment. So you can take it with you as an overhead item, and that's really good. However, it's extremely expensive, and in this video I'm going to go over all the pros and cons and if it's actually worth that price. Starting off with the basics though, the design is very simple. It's a single compartment box that has very durable latches that are lockable on the outside of it. You can opt for different color options from Pelican. You can get various inserts as well for the inside, such as foam inserts that are just little foam cubes you can pull out, the Trek Pack, which is hard dividers that you can lock into place, or these foam inserts that I got, which are essentially just Velcro and foam, and they're very modular and you can change it as many times as you like. Though, if you would like to get a cheaper option, there are third-party manufacturers that make different versions that fit inside this, so you can always opt for one of those, and they're quite a bit more affordable. This is a relatively lightweight case, coming in at 3.94 kilograms, which I know doesn't really sound light. However, compared to the previous version, the 1510, that was 6.17 kilograms. So this case managed to shave off quite a bit of weight without compromising really on the build quality in the slightest, and has held up really well for me over the years. I haven't been taking it off-roading it or throwing it into a lake to test if it's water resistant, but I can tell you with confidence, the gear inside has never gotten wet or even dirt or dust inside, and it's just been extremely durable. The heaviest hit it's taken has been a C-stand falling on top of it, and it never even made a mark. The only signs of wear really are on the edges of it, where it's actually been dragged along asphalt, and even there, it's just kind of roughed up. It's not any damage. And I do have a sick fascination with kind of sitting or standing on top of this case, because it's relatively speaking comfortable to do so, and it always holds my weight with ease. With regards to actually carrying the case around, there's three options on the exterior for carrying it. The first of which is the one I use most often, which is the rolling handle, which is a very typical luggage handle. And it simply just slides out from behind via this small lever, and there it is. And it's exactly what you would expect. It's a very nice handle that doesn't have a texture really to it besides just being plastic with no grip, but it is extremely handy to have. And I find the wheels on the bottom roll really nicely, and haven't gotten gunked up with any hair or junk inside them over the years that I've used it. And it stows away quite nicely. Significantly less nice is the handle right beside it, which is this very small, thin handle that is just rubberized, but it's just not very significant. And when you do fill this case up with kilograms of gear, it's not balanced incredibly nice, and I just find it difficult to use, and it hurts my hand after a while of carrying it. Opposed to that is the next handle, which is on the side over here, which is much more significant and makes up for all the lacking of that top handle. It's just a very handy, large grip that you can hold onto easily with nice, again, rubberizing on the bottom of it. So it's centered perfectly, so when you do have a heavy load, it's not gonna shift or have the stuff inside being jostled from being unbalanced. So this handle is great. The rolling handle's great. It's just this little top handle is rather rubbish and is gonna be relegated to just when you need to pull it out of a compartment or just drag it somewhere quickly without having long carrying times. Moving on to actually getting inside of the case, I find the latches have held up really well over time and are easy to pop open and are just simple levers that you crack open, and it's as simple as that. I find the biggest differentiating factor between lower quality cases and higher quality ones is these latches. And when it's the main means of getting in and out of your case, you certainly don't want them to be a point of frustration. And I found certainly with this one, they're not an issue, and On newer versions, actually, there's spring-loaded buttons that pop it open. And I think that's actually a way better option than these ones. However, I'm not gonna buy a new case just to get that feature. There is the option to lock the case via these metal rings on the outside. However, I don't do so regularly just because if someone's gonna steal something from inside your case, they might as well just take the whole thing because it's not that difficult to grab. So I don't lock it for that reason. Once you open up the case, it's relatively simple. It's just one compartment with a couple of foam inserts. On the top, by default, it comes with this just simple piece of foam that fills the void of the top lid. You can choose to get a zipper compartment that you can switch this out for that basically adds a whole bunch of zippers to the top. I did not get this, mainly just because it costs extra money, and I'm normally carrying a backpack with me anyways for my small items, so I'm not gonna put it inside my case, and this provides a little bit of extra cushion that I quite like. And as I said at the start of the video, you can get different inserts for the bottom. I opted for the Velcro foam inserts, which have held up really well over time. And the bright yellow color of this insert makes it very easy to identify gear once you put it inside. And you don't necessarily need to look as closely at stuff just because the black on white is very easy to see stuff. And the Velcro has held up well as the stitching. And underneath this, there's nothing really. There's just a couple of foam inserts to fill the voids on the edge where the back handle makes a little bit of a divot. Otherwise, it's not terribly exciting. The interior compartment also has a pressure valve. So if you are taking it on a plane, there's a one-way valve that doesn't let in any water, but will allow it to not have any damage from pressure changes on the exterior. At the end of the day though, what it's going to come down to is the price, and it's an expensive case. It comes in at $200 US or 280 Canadian with nothing inside it. And if you want to get the foam inserts like I got, it's $310 US or 440 Canadian. I got mine on sale, but at any price point, it's hard to rationalize the price. And if you want to get the Trek Pack insert, it's even more expensive. So I can't fault it in terms of its quality. It's extremely well built and reliable. However, there's other options out there like from Nanook or Amazon Basics, which are considerably less expensive and have almost just as good of a build quality. I think what it comes down to is what you plan to use the case for. And for myself, I'm putting tens of thousands of dollars of gear inside this case. And at that point, the price, relatively speaking, becomes much less important. And the more important thing is, does it do the job it promises? And this case certainly delivers. It has held up really well, and I don't have anxiety whenever I'm taking it around, perhaps on a location where there could be unexpected weather, because I know my gear is gonna be safe inside here. And that's really all I wanted when I got it, and it's done that. However, it is important to acknowledge that there are better value options out there, and you're not just buying this because it's a Pelican case and it's good. It is certainly good, but it's not going to be the best value. And if you don't plan on using it a ton, you might not get your monies out of it. So it's just important to bear that in mind. Otherwise, I highly recommend it, and I think it's a fantastic case to throw your stuff inside. Anyways, that's going to be it for the video. I hope you found it useful, and if you enjoyed it, maybe consider liking the video or leaving a comment below. And if you had any questions, please feel free to ask. I love to answer them in the comment section, and I try to reply to all of them. Anyways, thanks again for watching. I hope you had a fantastic day, and I'll see you in the next video. Also, if you're wondering why this video was shot in a 4:3 aspect ratio, it's because it's the Snyder cut. It's much more cinematic, and you get the full view of everything in the frame now. It's actually because I couldn't get my camera far enough back to shoot it in the 2:1 that I normally do, but I'm gonna say it's because I wanted to be more cinematic, and it's a 4:3 crop.